Yes, bro. How are you? So this Brazil trip looks crazy. Can you guide us through what's actually happening?
We leave Friday night, fly from London. I'm going to land in Brazil at 5 a.m. Gives you a couple of hours to sleep. Then we have the first show. We don't have much time at the first show. We've got to jump on the jet and get to the next show.
You ready?
Yep, we've got two shows in one night.
Nice.
What is going on?
Then we have 6 hours sleep and then have to go on another flight.
Where are we flying to?
To get to somewhere else, yeah. To do another festival. Yeah, we got another show the next night back, in the middle of the night. So we've got to take another jet to get another show.
Can you actually believe this is our life? Look.
So on the third day, we've got two shows again. We have a bit of rest, so we've got time to chill and that beforehand. But we get another jet.
Yep. Another jet. Yep. 3 days, three jets.
We have 1 day break, but that break is a 10-hour flight.
The break is the flight.
Yeah.
All right, bro. This is gonna be fun. Let's fucking go. Transition. James Hyde.
Welcome to Sao Paulo. I just got off an 11 and a half hour flight and we are here in Brazil for Carnival. Let's fucking go. How are you guys feeling?
I'm feeling good.
Well, good. We've got Johnny with us, who is going to be our local guy here in Brazil to make sure we don't get into any crazy situations. I think that's why he's here. But we wouldn't do anything like that anyway. We've just been eating some breakfast and checking out the club that we're going to today, right? The first show of six is at this place called La Rock Club. And can you see that all right?
Yeah.
So look at this place. How do we swipe through? Oh my God. they've got this kind of crazy ceiling. It looks so cool. So yeah. This is going to be a pretty special show. We've got a couple of hours to get ourselves together after the long flight. Been a long time since I played in Brazil. Got to make sure I've got the right kind of music ready for the set tonight. And let's do this. Transition.
It's all right there, isn't it?
Welcome to La Rock. That's outside right now. It's raining. They don't seem to care. I don't care because I'm from England. Come on, look at this. The best drink in South America.
How do you pronounce it?
Don't know, Wallace. How do you pronounce it? Guarana?
Guarana.
Guarana.
Yeah.
Thank you.
That's why we've got Johnny.
Okay, all right. I'll be fast, bro. I'll be fast.
I took less than 5 hours. That was actually serious. That was
Does that make me crazy?
you just made it out of a club in less than 7 minutes.
That was amazing.
Oh, thank you. Great. Well, thank Rush, to be honest. But
thank you for your service.
Thank you. And now we're going straight to a jet. That's why we're in a rush, because we're going straight to another club, and apparently there's a jet and there's traffic and all types of stuff. So transition.
Johnny, what? Says it's back there.
Huh?
The airport says it's back.
Are we lost?
Yeah, he's right on.
Yeah, he missed it, yeah.
How long have we got until the plane takes off?
5 minutes.
Will it wait for us?
Yeah, they're waiting for us.
They're waiting?
Yeah.
God, I like this kind of plane. Okay, cool. Relax, everyone.
Rashaan, relax.
Always use Google. Never use Waze.
Thank you, mate.
Cheers.
Wow. That was impressive. Didn't expect to just walk out and be like in a plane garage.
Plane garage.
Hey Wallace, you want to go around that? You ready?
I'm ready, bro.
Hey, bro.
What's
up, man?
The way it is, yeah.
It's alright, by the way, you look
sure. No, I'm cool, sure. No, it's because I know how James feels about heights, isn't it? So I'm just like, look at him, man.
I'm feeling the speed on this today. Like, how you feeling?
I'm great, how are you feeling?
Yeah, I'm great, mate. Absolutely great, lad. As long as I got my guarana, we're good. How many of these do you reckon you can drink in a day without it being bad for you?
I haven't tasted it yet.
I think I've had 6.
Oh wow.
Yeah. It's been a long day though. Ooh, it's horrible, doesn't it? The worst thing is, you look out the windscreen, all you can see is a fucking cloud. Anyway, we're on the way to Rio de Janeiro, Marina da Gloria, to play at Privilege Festival, which is pretty crazy. We've gone from one epic club to a festival. And when we get there, I'm on at 2 a.m. So 3:30 a.m. It's gonna be good. That show, hang on, should we do a debrief?
Yeah, let's do it. Yeah. Let's do it.
All right, I give it a 9.5. It's fucking amazing. Bro. It was amazing.
Same, 9.5.
You never give 9.5.
I know, bro.
Yeah, that was a really special show. What a fucking club. Everything about that club was amazing. So cool to see people with a fucking banner. Who does this banner all the way out here in Brazil, Sao Paulo? Sorry, trying to focus with the plane change speed. Played loads of new tunes. That was fun.
Epic.
I got no complaints. I just, you know, I'm not allowed to give a 10. Over to you.
I have no complaints. Yes, I said it. I have no complaints.
That's never happened.
Big up the tech. The whole team was epic.
Yes. Thank you to everyone at La Rock, because that was really special. On to Rio. Let's see what you can do. Transition that way.
How you feeling, bro?
I really need the bathroom. I'm so American. I really need a piss. But we've got to get in the car and get to this club. Don't know what I'm going to do. I don't even know which car is off. Everyone looks kind of scary. Wallace, I'm scared.
Yeah. So basically what's going on right now, we're in the van on the way to this second show, and we've been looking on social media to find out what the stage looks like, and we keep seeing these pictures that every DJ who's played is using the V10 mixer and CDJ 3000s. Now, real hype, I'm already knowing my rider is DJM 900 and CDJ 2000s. Now, Rashaan's been emailing these people weeks and weeks and weeks saying, do you definitely have the equipment? Do you definitely have the CDJ 2000, DJM 900? And they've been ignoring his emails, or they've been saying it is approved, but avoiding the going around the, avoiding answering. So now I'm supposed to be on in 25 minutes and they haven't got my equipment. And I don't even know what's going to happen here. I really don't know what's going to happen. I don't want to let people down. But like, it's 25 minutes, and will you expect me to do what I do on a mixer that I've never even used before?
I really don't know.
It's really up to you now. The mix is there. Whether or not it works or not, I don't know. It's 3,000. Whether or not the mixer works or not, I don't know. Because it's just sitting on the side.
Alright, you gotta do it then?
Yeah?
Yeah.
Cool. Alright, we're gonna do it. We got 8 minutes.
Is it set up?
No, they're gonna stop it and do it.
What's happening, bro?
All right, so basically, we found a compromise. They managed to find a DJM 900. They haven't found the decks, but I'm a fucking nice guy, so I'm gonna play for the people of Rio de Janeiro on the wrong fucking decks. Thanks, everyone. Let's go.
Woo! And Charlie's here.
Crazy. Oh, get it. I'm guessing you just saw that. I literally felt like I was being stitched up. I don't know what the fuck is going on at this, but I feel like I'm being an asshole, but you've seen the video. Yeah. We got here, they told us that they didn't have any of the equipment, right? So we were like, oh fuck, well, what are we gonna do? Because I can't DJ on that equipment you've got, right? Then, like 2 minutes before the set, they were like, oh, we've managed to find a DJM 900, lo and behold, right? So then they found some of the equipment. So I'm like, okay, listen, I want to play to these people. Some of them have traveled a long way to come and see me and shit. I want to play to them. So I'm going to take the L, play on the equipment that I don't use because I want to play to these people. I start the set, we're delayed because nothing's fucking plugged in and shit. And then the first mix I do, the CDJ skips on me because that's what they do. That's why I don't use them. When you're transitioning around the track using quantize, I was using beat jump. I did a 16 beat jump, which I do all fucking day on CDJ 2000s. You do it on CDJ 3000s, suddenly they're not in sync with each other anymore. And you hear it clang, so you got to pull the fader down. First mix I did, absolutely abysmal because of the decks that I don't use, that I chose to use to be nice, right? Next thing you know, I can't see what's going on. I'm like, wow, it's getting kind of smoky. First of all, I'm like, I was getting kind of smoky. Wallace will be annoyed because it'll be bad for the video, right? When it's a bit smoky, it gets too much for the video, right? But then it kept coming and I was like, yo, what? Is this like, what's going on with it? And then before long, I couldn't see. I literally couldn't see the people behind me and shit. I don't know what it looks like on the camera, but like,
you could barely see you.
It was fucking ridiculous, man. And it wasn't stopping, it was still coming. And it was like, it's like no one's in charge or something. I fucking know, bro. But like, these guys said to me, like, I have to stop. Like, and I was, obviously, it's hard. It's really hard because I saw Stereohype shirts in the crowd and that's fucking horrible, man. Like, I want to play for those people. But at the same time, the festival has to be fucking organized properly for people to actually perform in the way that they're supposed to. People want to see me do what I do. So to do that, I need the right equipment and I need to not be drowned in smoke. I don't really know where we're going now. We're stuck in the dressing room and someone else has, luckily someone else has started DJing.
I'd like to say, shout out to the Hype fam that had a custom helicopter shirt.
Oh, mate,
album artwork.
Got it.
You
But
if there's a clip,
please
put the clip on.
Please, thank you so much.
Debrief gang.
Debrief gang. Well, that was so disappointing, and I'm sad and I'm sorry, and I just wish that things like that didn't have to happen. But we tried everything that we could to do that show. And,
we did. We tried.
We really did. Like,
yeah.
I know so many people who would have just said fuck off the minute they got there. So we really did. Like, we were already compromising on things, and you shouldn't be compromising when it comes to performing. As soon as we made that compromise, everything else just fell apart, and it was like, whoa, this is bad. And I was absolutely heartbroken because I saw the hype from there, and I hate not being able to play to people who've come out of their way to see me, and it really, really hurts. And just let it be a lesson to people to just do what you said you'll do in it.
Yeah. Be respectful, that's it.
Yeah. Ow. This is a hard thing behind me. You're right. All right, we got to fly to
Sao Paulo
at like lunchtime, yeah?
Yeah.
You're going to get about 7 hours sleep, I think, which is actually really good because I thought we were getting way less than that because he was so dramatic about it. I thought we were like 1 hour sleep for the whole week. So we're going to bed.
It's been a fucking long day. It's literally a day since we left London today.
Yeah.
Sort of. Transition by. Humidity. All right. Good morning. I feel fucking great, man. Had a full night's sleep, went to the gym, drank some water, drank some guaraná, and let's go. I can't even remember where we're going, but we're going. I'm about to make a video for the people explaining what the fuck happened last night, because I'm still pissed off and upset, and I feel like I disappointed people, but really, it wasn't my fucking... I did everything I could. Let's fucking go. To Sao Paulo. It feels like it's gonna rain. It's really gray. It's not even that hot. Apparently we're going to a helicopter now, which I've only just found out. What a fucking life, man. Let's go.
An intro this.
Here we go. Where are we flying to?
You know the name. I can't say the name.
Where are we going?
To Guarujá.
It sounds like the drink.
Yeah.
Guarujá. Fucking hell, bro. I love this shit.
The helicopter.
How was that, bro?
Oh, sick, man.
Let's
do this. Everything's okay. It sat down for a while. Had like 2 hours in the artist room. Time to go to the stage, let's fucking do this. When I went to the stage last night, I did loads of jumps beforehand and then walked through people and they were like, hey James, nice to meet you. And I was like, hello. Might happen again. It looks amazing out there, by the way. Wallace and Rash have already been out.
Rash, how's it look?
Epic. All right, let's do this. It's fucking crazy in here.
Yo, you ready for the fastest debrief ever?
Why?
Because this helicopter's about to take off.
Woo!
Rate the shot out of 10.
7.
I give it a 6.5. That's really fun. I don't want to, but I have to. We had to switch out two pieces of DJ equipment, which is like, that's quite extreme. And it broke my fucking heart because of what happened last night. Literally, we had this DJ mixer that for some reason, when you turned the effects knob, the whole mixer went to half the volume. I've never known anything like this before. Like, it was fucked, bro. You saw the clip, Wallace, and sent a clip of my face. Like, I was like, this is not happening to me. This is fucking so unfortunate. Luckily, the team had the replacement equipment, so they switched it out. And then one of the CDJs, the hot cues didn't work either. So the team had a replacement for that, and they switched it out too. Not ideal. It was way better than last night, though. I'm not complaining to the same level as last night. The reason I rate it so low as well, there was this hole in front of under the DJ table. Sorry, you can hear it's getting loud now. And I couldn't stand in the right position because I was worried I was like gonna fall through the stage, and it was kind of like a bit disturbing. Rash, explain your rating, please.
The reason I rated it 7 is because we had to change the mixer and the deck. But you did well.
Thank you. I think we all did well. The Hype Fam were amazing and the venue's really fucking cool. So, sorry, we had a bit of a negative start to the set, but overall, I do like it in there. I really do. Let's get up in the air. Bye.
Can you actually believe this is real life? Can you actually believe this is our life? Look at this. Watch out for that thing. I wish everyone could experience this. Look.
Jeez.
Crazy, bro.
The dance floor is my church.
We're in Belo Horizonte.
Yeah,
just got off the jet. Everyone's asleep.
I'm just really, really tired. I've got a show in 3 hours. Just went to the hotel, straight off the show. Back on the plane. To the last two shows in Brazil. Mad.
Transition.
James, you seen Wallace?
What?
You seen Wallace?
Are you joking? Are you serious?
I mean, dead serious.
Oh my god. Boy, did that hurt? Let's go! Already? Yo!
Are we ready?
Yeah, did anyone go to sleep?
No. Did you?
Yeah.
What?
I slept for like 3 minutes, but like. Well, no, I set my alarm for 20 and I was just counting fucking nothing for like most of it. But then when my alarm went off, I was asleep. So I was gassed. We're about to go to the second show. The only reason, I wouldn't have normally gone to sleep, but the fact that we got to go straight to the airport after is like, if I can grab like 1 minute of sleep now, it's like, it might save my life. Not to be dramatic. Get in the van, Wallace.
What? Which football club plays here?
Cruzeiro and Atletico.
See, we're in a football stadium. What are you thinking of a lift gang? That's nice, it's kind of flimsy. Let's not. Stop it, Wallace.
Yes, we're in a football stadium now. We're about to play this second festival of the day. I actually don't feel that bad, you know.
How mad?
Wow. Yeah. Oh wow.
Shit.
Sick. Oh, and they got the food.
Fucking
way. Yo, I'm trying to like get some sort of a set ready for this because I haven't played a closing set for a while. I'm just kind of shifting around the order of some of these records that I've been playing.
Because the set I've played the last 2 days has been going well, but it relies, I've got a lot of like key moments that are quite late in the set and I just want to bring them forward. Because I'm scared everyone's going to leave. but yeah, moving some shit around, taking some shit out that wasn't flowing too well. And
it's fucking dude.
The sun's coming up, man. It's gonna look so crazy when I'm on. I think in 10 minutes it's gonna be full daylight. I'm on in 20 minutes. Wow, let's go. This sign.
I've got to sign this. Autograph to tattoo.
No pressure.
Oh my god, that's fucking cool. That's so cool.
Sponsor
amusement.
Yeah,
that's
cool. Amusement.
It better be a good one, bro.
Hey, Chan.
It is good.
It's a good one.
James,
you got
picture,
a good one.
Picture.
James, James.
Thank you, thank you.
A picture.
Yeah, well, I'm a
James. Thank you. Oi. Please,
I loved your energy. I saw you in the front. Amazing. Please. Thank you.
James.
Oh, I wear the hat, yeah? Okay. Who
doesn't? Yep.
Debrief. I'm gonna keep this brief, no pun, because I've managed to secure us a jet for tomorrow so that we don't have to spend our whole, basically the plan was we were gonna go straight from this festival to the airport, then get two commercial flights to land in
Florianapolis.
Thank you, Wallace. Florianapolis at like fucking 4 p.m. or something to then play the set at 8 p.m., which would mean doing three sets without sleep, which is just fucking crazy. And I started to think maybe I'm gonna get sick if we do this. So I thought for the sake of me and the lads, I would try and find a jet that can take us there tomorrow. We're gonna be getting a jet at 4 p.m. It's now fucking 8:30. So we're gonna be able to go to bed for like 5 hours or something, which is better than no hours. Debrief says, I really enjoyed that show. It was exactly what I expected. I love playing a closing set because I learned to DJ by playing closing sets. I always used to play closing sets in Liverpool when I was doing the first ever gigs I ever did. So it always feels natural to me to do a closing set. It was cool to hang out with like Vintage Culture, and I met Mochak as well. I never met him before, so it was really cool. I'd give it, what do I give it? Give it 8.5.
Cool.
Yeah, really good. Downsides were, the decks were like vibrating off the table, and I didn't want to pull them back because I thought the cables were going to come out the back, so I was just like on the decks, minor. That's probably my fault for having the monitors too loud, because I'm deaf from all of the executive travel we've done today. Champagne problems. Rashan, do you want to rate the show out of 10 while we're stopped at these traffic lights?
8. Yeah.
Yeah, really good. All right, cool. Well, we're going to go to bed for a few hours and then we'll see you on another jet. This is the maddest episode of Moving Differently thus far. Transition.
It just put me right off.
Yeah, no, it's not. Say, it's not.
Carnival.
Nice hat, bro.
Thank you. I bought it. I was shocked.
So we're on our way to a jet now, and we're flying to Portofino,
Florianopolis.
Well, Florianopolis, and then we're going to do a show at 8 p.m. and then we're going to get in a car and go to Green Valley, which is one of the top 10 clubs in the world. We're going to play alongside Diplo, which will be really cool, and then we'll go to bed forever. Let's go.
It's raining.
What we got? Shit.
What are you saying? How are you feeling?
Quite asleep. Just ate food for the first time today. Like 30 minutes before DJ. Great. But if I didn't eat then I wouldn't get to eat, so.
Dance floor packed, that's without a doubt. That's without a doubt.
Sometimes it gets so dark, so dark it almost falls into the night.
it touches my soul. It quits the fire that burns in me, and I simply lose control. Sometimes it's all that's a misty thing that gently touches my soul. It quits the fire that burns in me, and I simply lose control.
To the number, Wallace, insert what number it is, club in the world, Green Valley. Do you follow what that meant? Yeah, yeah. I just couldn't remember what the number is, but it's pretty sure it's top 10. I'm just gonna rehydrate because I sweated a lot.
Yeah.
I am not built for this humid climate. So rehydrate, let's fucking go, let's do this. Oh my god, it's my last one. Oh my god. You got the ones you got, are the electrolyte ones?
I think so. Yeah. They say, I think they're the same thing as that.
Okay, cool.
Soon find out. Transition to the debrief.
Transition.
Debrief.
Debrief.
Debrief. Debrief. I think that was a really good show, but it was too hot. But maybe I'm just too British for this area of Brazil. Wallace is holding the camera really intensely. I give the show 8. I think the venue was really cool. People were really cool. And the sound and lighting and just like the layout of shit was really good. For some reason, one of the decks stopped by itself right at the start of the set, but I figured it was the bass vibrating the platter. Not meant to do that, but it did. So I just turned the monitors down and it didn't happen again. Solutions, Rashawn.
I have to give it an 8. Reason I'm giving it an 8 is due to the fact of it was more of like securing the DJ, the artist. That was more of my thing, like making sure that the actual booth itself was secure. That was more of my reason why.
Sick. All right. Oh, now we're going to Green Valley, but I can't remember what number it is anymore. Hang on. Right, now we're going to Green Valley, which is the number 3 club in the whole world. Sorry, this is pure waffle. Edit it. All right.
That's what. That's the only pitch that came up first, you know.
Green Valley, let's go. Transition.
All right, Green Valley, number 3 club in the world. Welcome to our fabulous dressing room. Even the fridge is green. Sorry, I got a movie. This is Spencer Brown, by the way.
Yeah, oh, that's good.
We're just about to go on stage. We're just like putting the finishing touches to the set because we're planning on filming the whole set tonight. So we've got to rush through this really fast so that Wallace can get into the crowd and stop filming. So yeah, transition, please.
One by one.
forward, but I can see the signs, recognize where we're going. So the less you give to me, the more I want. The less you give to me, the more I want it. You push me back until I'm two steps forward, but I can see the signs, recognize where we're going. So the less you give to me, the more I want it.
Welcome to the debrief. It is the next day and we need to talk about last night, because that is one of the best shows I've ever done, ever. What a fucking place, what a club. It's got to be one of the best clubs in the world, maybe the best club in the world, I don't even know. I'm going to give the show a 9.5, only because I can't give the show a 10. Let me find something wrong with it, because everything was right, it was perfect. The hype front were amazing. How are there that many people in a club? It's just crazy. The sound, the lighting, just honestly, I've watched videos back and I just can't even believe how good it was. And I really enjoyed it as well. Like, because sometimes you can do a really good show, but not actually enjoy it that much, you know? What do you rate it out of 10?
I have to second it. This is going to be my second one. 9.5.
Johnny, and rate it out of 10.
Rate it out of 10? 9.5. The 0.5 is because my arms didn't like to hold the camera for the whole concert.
Well, it's funny you say that, because I was going to say it's because I couldn't reach the other camera. That was it.
So I want to make a special thank you to Johnny for helping us out with the filming last night, because we couldn't have done it without him, and for guiding us around Brazil so we didn't die. And
Translating.
Guarana gang.
Guarana.
Thank you to Rashawn as well for fucking making all this crazy shit happen. And thank you to Wallace for documenting it all. So big up the whole team. It's been amazing. Thank you for watching. I've got nothing to plug. Who does this? Transition.
The beat is my religion. The dance floor is my church.